Let us find out the square root of this number, the square root of 0.4. When I put this question to the students, many of them, they reply that it is equal to 0.2. And the many others, they say it is 0.02. But when we take the value of this number with the help of a calculator, the calculator says that its value is around 0.632. So, to reach this answer, let us find out an easier way of finding the square root of any number which starts with a decimal. Now, two things. Number one, I am assuming that all of you know very well the method of finding the square root of a number with the help of long division method. And secondly, I am taking two similar figures. Here the figure is without a decimal and the same figure is with a decimal. This will help us to understand the concept in a better way. So let us start with the number which is a whole number which doesn't contain any decimal. So when we calculate the square of a number of a whole number, we start making the pairs from the right hand side. First pair is 25, second pair is 56. Now we have to start with 1. So 1, 1 and 1, 56 taken down, it is 2. So it is 2. So it is 44, 2 and 1, 25 is taken down. So 24, and it will be with 5. So 125 is the square root of 15,625. Now let us come to this problem. When we have to find out the square root of a number starting with a decimal, we make the pairs starting from the left hand side. First pair, second pair, third pair, fourth pair, and so on. This figure being a decimal number, we can put as many zeros as we require. Now we have to start with 15, so 0 point, that is the starting. Now 3 and 3, it is 9, so 6, 62, this is 6. 60 and 600, about 9. So when 69 is multiplied by 9, so it is 540 and 81, so 621. So we can put 621 over here. It is 1, 4. Now it is 78 and we take down 50, so 700 and about 5. So when we calculate, the answer of this figure will be 0.395. Now let us come back to the original problem of finding square root of 0.4. So when we find out the answer of this figure, we will take zeros like that. So first pair, second pair, now it will be starting from 6, 36, 4, double zero, so 12, it is 3, so 9 and 36, so it is 31, we take down 2 zeros, so it is 126, 1200, it is around 2. So now we have reached the same answer which was shown by the calculator. So whenever we interact with a figure which is starting with a decimal, we should start making the pairs starting from left hand side. Now there is another way of finding the square root of such numbers. Many people, they solve it like that. And the method is 0.4. It can also be written as 4 upon 10. So if we multiply numerator and denominator by 10, it will convert the denominator into a perfect square. So this will be equal to under root of 40 divided by 10. Here we have taken the square root of 100. So now what we are to do? We are to take the square root of 40. It will be around 6.32. Then we are to divide the answer by this 10. So again the answer will be 0.632.